Hello students, now in this video class we are going to discuss about 11th standard computer science chapter 2 number systems part 3. In the previous video class we discussed about what are the different types of number systems used in the computers. Okay, now in this video class we are going to discuss about each and every one in detail. So now we see about decimal number system. In this number system totally we are having 10 digits. That is, decimal number system consists of the numbers from 0 to 9. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Totally 10 digits is there. That's why we can say the radix or base value for decimal number system is 10. Okay. So it is the oldest and most popular number system. Day to day life we are using numbers for calculation now. That numbers are comes under this decimal number system only. In the positional number system, each decimal digit is weighted relative to its position in the number. That is, in mathematics you can say, 0th position, 10th position, 100, like that. Decimal numbers is also having the positional number system. This means that each digit in the number is multiplied by 10 raised to a power. Okay, 10 power 0, 10 power 1, 10 power 2, like that we can calculate the positional number. Corresponding to that digit's position, we can calculate the digit position by using 10 to the power. Okay, now you can see an example for this. So decimal number system 123 base 10. Okay, so base value always represented in below the number. Okay, is equal to, we must just multiply this number by 10 powers. Okay, it starts from 0, that is unit 0, and then 10 hundredths position. Okay, so where the position, the position of 3 is 0th position. Okay, so 3 into 10 power 0, and then 2 is first position, 2 into 10 power 1, that is the positions it starts from here like this, 0, 1, and then 2. Okay, this is the positional value for this given number. So you can take this position value and multiply by 10 to the power. Okay, so now you can calculate 10 power 2 is equal to 100. So 1 into 100 plus 2 into 10 plus 3 into 1. Now you can add all these numbers, we get the given number 123 base 10. Okay, so now you can see the next one, binary number system. We already know the computer can knows only the binary language. You can give any different kinds of data, that is text data, sound data, graphics or animated movies, whatever it may be. The system must convert all this data into the binary form. The binary data is only evaluated by the computers. Okay, so binary number system, in this number system we are having only two numbers, that is 0 and 1. Okay, so there are only two digits in the binary system, namely 0 and 1. So what is the base or radix value for this number system? The base or radix value for binary number system is 2. Okay, why you are saying 2? Number of digit present in this number system is only 2 digits, that is 0 and 1. So the base or radix for binary number system is also 2. Okay, the numbers in the binary system are represented to the base 2 and the positional multiplier or the power of 2. Okay, here the positional multiplier is power of 2. In decimal number system, the positional multiplier is powers of 10. Okay, here in binary number system, the positional multipliers are the powers of 2. Okay, the leftmost bit in the binary number is called as most significant bit. The leftmost bit, see this example, the leftmost bit is known as the most significant bit, and it has the largest positional weight. We starts from 0, the positional weight starts from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So which one is having the largest positional weight, the most significant bit? That is, MSB bit is having the largest positional weight. Okay, the rightmost bit is the least significant bit. The rightmost bit is known as the least significant bit. See this example, this is the least significant, that is LSB, and as the smallest positional weight, it has the smallest positional weight, that is it starts from 0. Okay, so LSB is having smallest positional value and MSB is having largest positional values. Okay, So now you can see an example of binary number system. The binary sequence 1101 base 2 and the decimal equivalent. Now you are going to find out the decimal equivalent of this binary number. Okay, how we can identify this is a binary number? In this numbers we are having only zeros and ones. Okay, binary numbers is having only two digit. What are the two digits? 0 and 1. Okay, here also we are having 1101. All are binary numbers only. Okay. So 1101 base 2 is equal to, how we can represent? We represent the positional value by 2 powers of, okay. The positional value for this number is first one is 0, 1 and then 2, 3. Okay, this is the weight for this given numbers, okay, positional value. So 1 into 2 power 0 and then 0 into 2 power 1 and then 1 into 2 power 2 and then 1 into 2 power 3. So we multiply this one, 2 power 3 is equal to 8, that is 2 into 2 into 2. 2 power 3 is equal to 8 and then 2 power 2, 2 into 2 is 4, 2 power 1, 2. Now 2 power 0, say anything power 0, the value is 1, okay. Anything power 0, the value is 1. So we can write 1 here. Now we can multiply this 1, 1 into 8, 8 plus 1 into 4, 4 plus 0 into 2, the value is 0, okay. 0 into 2, multiply by 0. It gives the result as 0, okay, plus 1 into 1, 1. So now the total value for this number is 13, 13 base 10. So the equivalent 1101 base 2 binary value equivalent of decimal number is 13 base 10, okay. So the equivalent value is 13 base 10. Now you can see about octal number system. So octal number system uses the digit 0 to 7. The total number of digit present in octal number system is 0 to 7. Totally how many digits is there? Totally 8 digits is there. Okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Totally how many digits is there? 8 digits is there. So the base or radix value for octal number system is 8. Okay. And then here the positional value or weight as a power of 8. Okay, now you can see the example for octal number system. That is the octal sequence 547 base 8 as the decimal equivalent. And now you can see what is the decimal equivalent of this octal number. How we can find out? We just multiply the number by their positional value, 8 powers. Okay, so 547. 5 into 8 power 2 plus 4 into 8 power 1 plus 7 into 8 power 0. So the positional value, it starts from 0. So 7 into 8 power 0, 4 into 8 power 1, 5 into 8 power 2. Okay, now you can multiply this one, 8 power 2, 8 8s are 64. 8 power 1 is 8 and then 8 power 0. Anything power 0, the value is 1. Now you can multiply this one, 320 plus 32 plus 7. Okay, we get this answer. Now we add all these things, we get the answer 359 base 10. That is 547 base 8. Octal number, equivalent decimal number is 5. 357. You can able to find how we can convert this one. We just multiply the octal number by the positional value with the power of 8. Okay. So now you can see the hexadecimal number system. In this number system, total numbers are present in this number system is 0 to 15. Totally we are having 16 numbers. Okay. 0 to 15. The total number of digits present in hexadecimal number system is 16. So the base or radix for hexadecimal number system is 16. Okay. So hexadecimal number is represented using base 16. How we can represent this hexadecimal number system? So the numbers from 0 to 9, as it is, you can represent 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. After 9, we represent the each numbers equivalent to their alphabetical letters. That is, instead of representing 10, we just represent A and then 11, B, 12, C, D, and then 13 D, 14 E, 15 F. Like that you must represent for hexadecimal number system. Okay. So hexadecimal number system is also represented by X numbers, H-E-X, X numbers are used as a shorthand from a form of binary sequence. Okay. So this system is used to represent data in a more compact manner. So this hexadecimal number system is used to represent a numbers in more compact manner, because here we require only 4 digits to represent. In binary number system, we require 8 digits to represent the numbers. Okay. So since 16 symbols are used, 0 to F, the notation is called hexadecimal. Okay. The first 10 symbols are the same as in the decimal system. That is the first 10 symbols. What are the first 10 symbols? The numbers from 0 to 9. Okay. And the remaining 6 symbols are taken from the first 6 letters. That is 6 letters of the alphabet sequence. That is A to F, where A represent 10, B is 11, C is 12, D is 13, E is 14 and F is 15. Okay. So this is the way you can represent the hexadecimal number system. Okay. Now you can see the example for hexadecimal sequence. The hexadecimal sequence 25 base 16 as the decimal equivalent. Now we are going to find out the decimal equivalent of hexadecimal number 25. How you can find out this is the hexadecimal number? We can also say this number is a octal number or decimal numbers also. Okay. So how you can say this is a hexadecimal number? We see the base value. Here the base value is given by 16. So 16 base means which number? It comes under the hexadecimal number system. Okay. So 25 base 16 is equal to 2 into 16 power 1 plus 5 into 16 power 0. So we just multiply this values. 16 power 1. What is the value for 16 power 1? 16. So 2 into 16 is equal to 32. Anything power 0, the value is 1. So 1 into 5, we get the value 5. So 32 plus 5 is equal to 37 base 10. Now we can find out the decimal equivalent of hexadecimal numbers. Okay. So how we can find out the decimal values? We just multiply the hexadecimal number by their positional value. That is their weight. Okay. So now you can see this table. In this table, the numbers are given. That is decimal equivalent number for binary, octal and hexadecimal. Okay, binary, octal, hexadecimal equivalent of decimal numbers. So in decimal 0, how we can represent 0 in binary number? 4 zeros. Okay, 0, 0, 0, 0. In octal number system, we use only 3 digits. Why we are using here 3 digits? Totally how many bits is there? 7, 8 bits, no? 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2. What is the value for that one? 2 power 0 is 1, 2 power 1 is 2, 2 power 2 is 4. Okay, 4 plus 2 plus 1. Totally how many bits is there? 7 bits. So we are using 3 digits. In hexadecimal number system, totally we are having 16 numbers. That is 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3. So we are having 15. Okay. So that's why we are taking 4 digit number system for representing the hexadecimal numbers. And then 1. How we can represent 1? Here we can represent 001. In octal number system 001, hexadecimal 001. So this table we just refer how to represent a decimal number in binary, octal and hexadecimal number system. So we see in the sequence 10, how this 10 will be represented in binary 1010. That is 2 power 0. What is the value for 2 power 0? Now we can see the example how we get the 10. Okay. So 10, what is the value is given? 10 10 10. Okay. So how we can convert this into decimal number? 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2. Okay. So the 2 power. So now you see how to get the decimal value 10 from this binary number. Okay. So 1010, we just substitute the positional value and multiply the 2 powers. Okay. The positional value for there is 0 is 0. So 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3. So anything power 0, the value is 1. 1 into 0, we get the result 0. 2 power 1, what is the value for 2 power 1? For 2. Okay. 2 into 1, we get 2. 2 into again 1, we get the value 2. Okay. Here 2 power 2, 2 power 2 is equal to 4. 2 into 2, 2 power 2 is equal to 4. 4 into 0, we get the value 0. 2 power 3, 2 into 2 into 2. So we get the total 8. 8 into 1, we get the result is also 8. Okay. So 8 plus 2, we add this numbers. 8 plus 2, we get the result 10. Okay. So this is the decimal equivalent value for this binary number, okay? And then we see this octal number, how we can convert this octal into decimal, okay? Here 0, 1, 2, 8 power 0, 8 power 1, we just substitute the positional value and then 8 power 2, the value of 8 power 0, anything power 0, the value is 1. So 1 into 2, we get the value 2. And then 8 power 1, 8 into 1, we get the value 8, okay. So 8 into 1, again multiply by 1, we get the value 8. 8 power 2, 8, 8 8s are 64, 64 into 0, we get the value 0, okay. Now we can add this number, 0 plus 8 plus 2, what we get the number 10, okay. The decimal equivalent is 10, okay. So the octal value 0, 1, 2, the decimal equivalent of this number is 10. Like that we can convert the octal number to decimal number or binary to decimal, as well as octal to hexadecimal to decimal numbers also, okay. See this, so after 9, the hexadecimal number for this number 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 are alphabetical letters. We can represent from A to F, okay. So A represented by 10, B is used to represent 11, C, D, E, F. Like that we can represent the alphabetical numbers for hexadecimal number system. Okay students, so today we discuss about 4 different kinds of number system and what are the numbers inside of this number system and what is the base value of this numbers, okay. In the next class we discuss about how to convert from one number system to another number system, okay students, thank you.